Welcome, everybody. Welcome to the finale of a very long and eventful season. 39 weeks of effort, energy, and work have come down to this. It's the 2023 ARCS season finale for the A-Square Cup Series here at Phoenix Raceway. We welcome you to our coverage here on ABN Esports One. I'm Carmen, Sienna. Alongside me, as always, Kevin Young. To finish off a season in style, four drivers will be battling for a championship here tonight. Tommy Reynolds, Brandon Fetterplace, Josh Gaiman, and Seth Wanzing. Kevin, this is obviously a place we've seen several times this year already. But just looking at the anticipation, it's a little bit different in how it feels tonight. Walk us through what these drivers are looking forward to tonight.
Well, we can start off for a fact here. It is a different atmosphere tonight. We do have stages, but those stages do not mean really anything other than pride. Four drivers coming in tonight know what they need to go. We'll talk about them a little bit more in detail through warm-up and other things, but we'll go through a quick little track update here first. It's a track where running kind of the low, like going off on restarts, you're going to go cut the dog leg aggressively, but hanging to the corners, you're going to see some drivers take different lines and different approaches. Most are going to try to hug that yellow line, be in that low to middle groove. Maybe a few as the run go on, we'll try and the tires come in, we'll get a little brazen and try to go just a little wider to try to get themselves a better run off. But tonight, it's after the real-life NASCAR series, all three of them have crowned champions officially. It's time for A-Square to finish this up and declare their champion here tonight. And with four drivers vying for that, it's going to be a quite fun night to see who could pull this off.
Absolutely, and as we walk through, we'll show the point standings as they enter. It all comes down to this. Four drivers on level footing. Josh Gaiman, Brandon Fetterplace, Seth Wanzing, and Tommy Reynolds will be battling for a championship. Reynolds, up until his win at Martinsville a week ago, was out of the running. Now back in, and it's hard to say that he's not a contender here at all. Currently qualifying underway has Fetterplace and Reynolds. Fetterplace, the regular season champion. Reynolds, season-long battle with Fetterplace, comes down here to this race. Seth Wanzing, the two-time series champion, would love to return to championship glory. And what a way to do that here. He's fought all the odds to get back to this position, and it all comes down to here. He's currently fourth in qualifying as things stand. And Josh Gaiman looking to make things happen. This track's not been kind to him. He comes in with the longest odds of all four drivers here tonight. But those odds, don't rule them out completely. You also see the rest of the field as we have them calculated here. Those that have been eliminated drop back down to the way the points were at the round of 16. So all the drivers 5th to 16th are based off of where they would have been. They're all in the same group of drivers there. Mm-hmm. So look at Daniel Michel, David Wright, Steven Overstat. Overstat, just based on points alone in the top 8, a phenomenal run for him for Beachron Racing. Feimster, Sears, Krueger in the top 10 as well. But I mean, wanted to make sure we had a complete package here points-wise. Again, as you mentioned there, no stage points tonight. It is just straight up go out and drive your butt off and try to get the race win tonight. But we've seen sometimes a spoiler can come in and sort of take that race win away. So again, it for the top four, best finisher matters. There's no bonus points here tonight. So that's going to be a big key to follow here this afternoon. Makes it easy for us not to do math in between stages. But for the drivers, it's a lot more crucial to get things right early and keep hold of things throughout this race tonight.
Yeah, and as you look through, like we were going through the drivers here, you're 100% correct there. Drivers have to do this correctly. Drivers have to be correct, and if you make a mistake or have an incident early, you're going to have to try to rebound quickly, and that's not easy. Drivers do have one fast repair, but that's kind of a chalk in the distance. If you burn it early, you're playing on the back, but you have to be more defensive. So different drivers will drive different ways here tonight to try to put it on a point. And for the rest, like looking at qualifying right now, Edward Marshall currently third fastest, highest of the non-playoff drivers. He could be a spoiler. He's not here for that. At best right now, he's going for himself and maybe to ensure line power locks up the constructors. That's the only two things he's really out there, and probably the win is more important than constructors to him at this time right now. But looking through the narratives right now, you got Brandon Fetterplace, regular season champion, had been strong, but only got one win at Gateway so far this calendar year. Looking to try to get another one when it matters most. Tommy Reynolds, like you said, 7 wins on the year, very strong, but was coming into Martinsville, was in a must-win situation. He did win here in the spring, and he's looking strong to at least repeat. Then you got Seth Wanzing, multiple-time champion here in A-Squared, only gotten 2 wins, a little bit on the lower side for him, looking and fighting some connection issues, looking to try to get it. And then Josh Gaiman, like I said, I wouldn't call him 100% a long shot, but he's been quite strong, but he's been very streaky. He's had great runs, but he's had problems finishing with those good runs, as you saw after winning at Texas. Las Vegas, last two rounds, he was good, but he won a lap down in both those races. So it's going to be interesting to see as qualifying has just finished up, and we are going to head to warm-up, and we're going to see what these drivers do for the last warm-up of the season.
Yeah, so the qualifying results, here they are on your screen, popping up now. Brandon Vettel plays pole position, a 27.620 is how he ends up taking pole position for the last time this season. Can the regular season champion take the crown tonight? We'll find out in about an hour and a half's time here this evening. Tommy Reynolds alongside him on the front row. It's going to be an action-packed front row on this start. Have to be perfect tonight among all nights. As you mentioned, Edward Marshall, his teammate's going to be right in front of him. Help your teammate when you can, but if no one's there to help, go for it yourself. He's alongside David Wright, who's already got a pair of wins this season. Looking for a third? He'd let the place floor here tonight as well. Seth Wanzing, two-time champion, comes in. This is his best run so far since his championship effort back in 2021. Can he do it again? That is a huge question. A lot of time between then and now. A lot of things have changed for Wanzing. But back in the championship fight, he starts on the inside of row three alongside Kevin Feimster, with Donald Ray and Josh Gaiman, the last of the playoff drivers, behind in row four. Talk about Josh Gaiman. Reason why we say he's a longer shot, this track's not been friendly to him. His average finish is 17th, worst of all the drivers at this track in the playoffs right now.
Mm-hmm. And that comes down to a problem where he's been good, but he's just been had trouble finishing high. He's qualified fine. He started okay. He's just gotten an incident, or he's went around, or he at home said, for instance, he's burned up his stuff too early, and he's just put himself in a bad spot. So he shines bright, but he shines inconsistent. But if he can make it work, he's going to do this strong here. So we'll see in this regard here. Again, you can't count any of these drivers. All these four have proven their worth here tonight and gotten the reason why they're here. One of them will walk away with the champion, and the other three are going to be sad about it, but at least they can say, hey, we put up a fight against whoever the champion may be throughout the whole year.
So we'll walk you through what all the championship contenders look like right now. Here's Seth Wanzing, the number nine machine. This is a car that Kyle Larson ran throughout the season, but it's got the Chase Elliott 9 font on it. Again, he is one of the playoff drivers, two-time series champion, would love to come back to become champion once again. But he's got to fight through three other drivers, one of them being Tommy Reynolds. This car has been pretty well run all season long for Tommy Reynolds. Tonight's no exception. Number seven car trying to find victory lane in a championship for the first time in the A-Square Cup Series. Likewise, not a lot to change. If it's not broke, don't fix it. Brandon Vetter place. Ghost Energy number 34 on pole position tonight. Go for a spin on the apron there, approaching pit lane. And there was, I believe, the four of Austin Mongold running a throwback scheme. And then Josh Gaiman, another car that has not changed too often much in how it's looked this season. Number 61, again, starts down in eighth position tonight. See what he can do here at Phoenix. Again, a track he's not done very well at. You can chalk it up to a lot of different things. But again, that average finish among all competitions that ABN's broadcasted do not lie. 17th is lower than everybody by at least 10 positions. Next lowest would be Wanzing, whose average finish is 7th at this track. Vetter place. Reynolds, they're both average finish here at Phoenix, fourth or better.
Mm-hmm.
So stats are going to be interesting to follow here tonight. Some people have to defy the odds. But this is how legends are made here at Phoenix Raceway. With about a minute left here in warm-up again for everyone just now making their way in. It's been a wonderful championship night, and it does not end yet. We have a wonderful race on tap here this evening. Part of a busy schedule here on ABN Esports. We had a doubleheader yesterday, the Platinum Endurance Championship, 10 hours of Hockenheim, and then the Brooklyn 150 for the ARCS Saturday Night Showdown last night. Tomorrow we'll be in Milwaukee for the HTL Cup Series. It'll be a fun race there as well. And the Truck Series, I believe, is also heading to Milwaukee, if I'm not mistaken. Gonna double check on that.
Yes, Truck Series is going to Milwaukee. You are correct. Interesting to note, you weren't here for that, but the two top three finishers both hadn't bought the track yet. So it's going to be interesting to see them next week when at least a couple of them are going to be racing on fresh ground at the very least.
Absolutely.
Lisa Lillia Pelletier-Sharp, who did get third in that race, did have likes the track, so we'll see what she can do on that point. But we'll focus on the main bread and butter of A squared, as this is going to end in warm up here in 10 seconds. It is going to be two pace laps, a little bit different than we usually see at Phoenix. Well, it is usually two, but they're going one, but they're going to extend it to the second one just to let the pageantry play out. So
yeah, a little bit of a salute to the season. Mm-hmm. So again, this has been a long season. Season started all the way back in February, and now here we are once again. Kick off the season in style. Here we go. Yeah, and track information for those that missed it, mile-long track. A little bit different than what we're used to. But it's got that flair all on its own. Dog leg right below the yellow line. We're looking at it right there. All that's legal. And you'll see drivers use it all night long. It's going to be aggressive. It's going to be physical here tonight. 105 degrees, the track temp. Air temp, 79 degrees. Not too awful bad. It is a little bit humid. It's a little bit sticky around the air here, but next to no winds makes it a little bit more stable here tonight. The starting grid, we talked about it before. Brandon Vettel place, Tommy Reynolds on the front row, Marshall in right row two, Wanzing and Feimster row three, Donald Ray and Josh Gaiman row four, then Sears, Mongold, LaJoy, and Pinnell rounding out the top 12. Ryan Pinnell, this is a cherry on top. His favorite driver just won the championship in the NASCAR Cup Series like an hour ago. Mm-hmm. So he's just here to celebrate, and what a way to celebrate an end of a season here in style for the fourth season. The A Square Cup Series comes to an end here at Phoenix. Brandon Proudfoot, Bren Roberts in row seven, and on his own in row eight, Tommy Withers to round out the field here tonight. Phenomenal stuff so far. We're going to have a live prediction in our live Twitch chat. Ooh. Use your channel points. Use your eddies. Tell us who you thinks it'll win tonight.
Honestly, I don't know if I should, as a commentator myself. I mean, I may vote in the chat, but I don't know if I'm going to vote personally on a stream, because I don't want to jinx someone. All right, I want to keep the prediction up front and let these drivers race out, because I remember back at Daytona where I called, oh yeah, I think driver X will make the playoffs, and they had the worst race of their whole A-square career. So I think I'm going to keep my prediction myself personally here. If you want to throw something out there, Carmen, you personally can, but if you are here, the audience, we're here, vote who you want to vote for. I know one person in the chat's definitely going to be voting for Feather Place, but we'll see how the rest of the viewers decide to vote here. So use your channel points and decide who you think is going to be the victor.
Again, Nat is now active in our live Twitch chat here tonight. Again, extra formation lap here tonight. Everyone's got 30 minutes to make your submissions. Who do you think is going to be champion at the end of this race? We're going to find out in this race. 156 laps here tonight. Three stages in this race, but none of the stages score points for the first and only time this season. Super important. Stages end on lap 25 and 60. But again, all of that means nothing points-wise. Just about being there at the end here tonight. Kevin, it's been a long season. Obviously, we get to work again on Tuesdays even still. But let's end this season in style. Pace car is in pit lane to the restart zone. The championship finale is underway. We're racing at Phoenix.
As you can see, Tom Sears already kind of hits the wall right there a little bit. Gets a little loose there. I was about to say something else, but Sears got a little wobbly, but he'll get it, at least keep it in the right direction. But lap one in the books here, and it's going to be Brandon Featherplace leading lap number one as Tommy Reynolds is under approach from Edward Marshall and his championship rival Seth Wanzing at the moment. So we'll see how that battle forms out for third here, because the rest of the cars beginning to file in and file out. It's a magical night. And right now, Featherplace pulling away at the moment with his teammate in tow, who could be a bit of a help here. Because right now, looking at least with allegiances, it does help to have friends in high places and low places to kind of help guide out and make your life a bit easier. And with Edward Marshall having the second position at the moment, He's looking good. Lee's clear. Reynolds, but Reynolds keeping it aggressive around the high side at the moment.
Marshall got loose, looking for a lane.
Yep. Marshall could not keep it planned. That's going to open the door for David Wright and Josh Gaiman to follow through here. So Edward Marshall's going to have to try to get back on his horse and try again. But at least he kind of could put that in the back of his mental box to signify what he needs. But right now, it's still the Feather Place show up front with Reynolds and Wanzing right in tow.
For those that are tuning in and haven't been used to how we have things marked here, if you see drivers marked in red, like Feather Place, our race leader right now, they are championship contenders. There's four of them in this race. It's Feather Place, Reynolds, Wanzing, 1, 2, 3, Josh Gaiman in fifth. All four contenders in the top five at the moment, similar to how we saw it last season when Jeremy Breo took the crown from Jacob Blankenship. Mm-hmm. Right now, Feather Place leads, the regular season champion. Tommy Reynolds, the winningest driver this season. Seth Wanzing, the only defending, only former series champion in contention here tonight.
Yep. You got three different titles on three different drivers. I think a car got loose in the back there. They're going to hit the inside
wall. Kevin Feimster.
Yep, Kevin Feimster. Big lick for the 21. Rocking a bit of a new paint scheme. Threw me off for a second. He is going to get it fired back up. But similar to Sears, he had an incident where problem occurred, and he'll get it re-going, but he's definitely going to have some damage on that machine. Battle for second, though, heating up is now Wanzing. Going to try to make a run on that seven, just a little bit far back right now, but he feels comfortable on that low side. Tommy Reynolds likes the high side, but we saw that bite him in the rear at Hopes Miami. Now, obviously, different tracks, different environment, different everything, even different locations. The only thing you could say is similar is the heat index chart, but the problem is that Reynolds could burn up his stuff just a bit too much here, and it could put him behind the eight ball, and if that's the situation, he doesn't want to be it. But right now, he's looking okay in second. It looks like he's now boogieing it down the racetrack a little bit, trying to drive where Feather Place isn't and hold on.
And there, you saw him get loose there. Sorry to cut you off there. He got loose there a little bit, and they're going to push a little bit because the stage is only 25 laps, so they're not going to feel too much of the effects of the tire wear in this stage. It's the stage, the second stage, where I think drivers are going to figure out a lot more about where they stand longevity-wise here tonight. But Reynolds showing he's not afraid to let it loose a little bit and find those limits early.
Yeah. Is he Wanzing right there? Gaiman is getting, I wouldn't say getting held up, but he's getting good runs right on that 42 machine, but he just can't really put something on. Similar to Wanzing right now, he just can't really get the run he needs in the corner right now. Maybe he's playing a bit cautious here. He doesn't have to really push past the 42 right now at the moment, as again, stage points mean nothing. Don't put yourself in a spot where you're going to end up wrecked. But he's going that point there. Wanzing just in the foreground made a move on Tommy Reynolds for second. So one car goes around one, and now Gaiman, I think, is going to get successfully around the other, so you can just see in the background. So two separate battles happening right now at the moment. Carmen trying to keep up here, trying to keep both in the shot. But both the 9 and the 61 gained a spot, and the 7 and the 42 lose a spot.
Again, stage one. Again, no points in this stage. So right now, everyone's just kind of just figuring out things. Just trying to make sure they don't lose too much position. All four championship contenders have made it to the top four here. Obviously, and we've talked about this before. We've whittled it down to four of the best drivers in this series for this race. And now Josh Gaiman's clear of David Wright. How quickly can he get to the bumper of Reynolds and Wanzing? And obviously, passing somewhat difficult in these cars here, especially as runs go on. How quickly can he get around them in this race?
And that's where, again, obviously not in the first stage. Again, tires not really that big of a concern, but later on, second stage or even final stage, saving your stuff could be a bit of a help to get around those cars. Let the cars ahead burn your stuff up and then take advantage and capitalize ahead of get around them in that regard. But we'll have to see how that all plays out in regard. But the one positive, obviously, closer you get to the front, better chance you are to keep a position or maybe even leapfrog a car when the pit cycle opens up or the first stage ends and drivers elect to pit on lap 25. So getting closer, getting up a spot could end up helping you out in that regard. So we're cutting through the field here, looking through things. Here's Michael Joy and Ben Roberts. We're cutting previously. We're looking on, I believe, is Feimster and Proudfoot. So two different battles we're watching here. The 54 machine here. Like a nice high groove in that coffee-inspired paint scheme, but a little too high at the moment. And looking to at least keep that car planted now back on the lower side here. Not really enough for Brent Roberts to get a good run. Donald Ray to get a good run on Brent Roberts.
Yeah. I'm kind of perusing through some of the battles here. David Wright now under attack from Edward Marshall, the 42 and the 16 going at it for fifth position. And both these drivers have lost spots on the opening stanza here as Proudfoot takes on Kevin Feimster in the battle for 13th position right now, and trouble still for Tom Sears, and that looks like way more significant damage on that 14 car in that left front.
Yeah, it looks like he had a similar incident what he had on the opening lap there, except pounded the wall a little bit harder. He's just trying to nurse it home to the end of the stage here where he can either fix it up or take the fast pair if needed, but he's just trying to hang on at the moment and not try to end up looping it around and causing a caution here. But back up to the top four here, 1-2-3-4 in the championship, 1-2-3-4 on the racing surface right now. Gaiman has slowly reeled in this pack, but similar to them, Reynolds and Wanzinger, Wanzinger Reynolds, have caught Feather Place. So it's in this kind of a situation right now at the moment. We'll see how it all plays, but Wanzinger Reynolds is getting the run on that 34. Question is, will he elect to try to take a pass?
I think we're going to find out here pretty shortly. I think at this point, we're coming to 10 laps to go in stage one. Again, stage one ends on lap 25 here tonight. Brandon Feather Place currently leads our votes as far as who fans think are going to win this championship. Feather Place, 48% of the votes so far. Then it's Gaiman, then Reynolds, then Wanzing in that order as far as who people think are going to become champions. So the fans so far making it loud and clear. They think it's going to be between one of the three main contenders we've seen so far this season. All three drivers that have been sort of, that've gotten a lion's share of the votes here on multiple wins stuff. Wanzinger, race winner as well. I think people overlooked that Wanzing's race win at Gateway was really well earned as well. And that should help Wanzing out a lot because this is a track where you have to make compromises. It's not a symmetrical track at all.
For our prediction, it was actually Feather Place who won at Gateway, not Seth Wanzing. Seth Wanzing won at Kansas in the chase,
correct.
And he won at one
That's
other
correct.
Track
he won at home.
Beforehand. Yeah.
He won at Kansas, and then he won at Nashville. That's my mistake.
Trust me, how many mistakes I've made so far this season, you at least got double on me at the moment.
I just got home from Texas. That's my excuse.
Yeah. Glad that you could join me at least for this finale here. Get a nice little show going as the stage is rapidly closing up here. Lap 19, almost a hit the wall there for the 9 car there. You can see a puff of smoke pop up. Little harm, no foul touch though, as he'll keep it rolling here. We got a little bit further back here. David Wright under pressure from Edward Marshall. This is 5th and 6th we're currently watching on at the moment. Marshall, remember, qualified P3, had that little loose moment. He's got a fast 16. He's got to try to keep it stable to try to get back up there, trying to maybe play a bit of a spoiler here and do what Proudfoot did at Texas and be the spoiler to the rest of the field. But we'll see how that all plays out in according.
It's going to be very hard to do when you have all four championship contenders in the top four right now. And as close as they are, the closest battles so far are all in this top four. They are nose to tail. Feather Place beginning to pull away a little bit as Wanzing begins to struggle on those tires here. But again, a reprieve in about 6 laps time as Reynolds finds it really wide on the outside lane. Josh Gaiman follows him, so pretty consistent line up there on the outside lane as they try to make a late apex through turns 1 and 2. We'll ride on board with the driver that has the most wins this season, Tommy Reynolds, with that honor. Make sure I got the right camera angle.
There we go.
So right on board with Tommy Reynolds at the moment. Going through turns 1 and 2 right now. I'll give you an idea as to how difficult this Phoenix Raceway is in these stock cars. We see Phoenix a ton. See it in champ car from Atlantics. Mm-hmm. Modified, late models, trucks. Obviously stock cars here. 3,500 pound stock car, 670 horsepower. Not a lot of downforce on these cars either. You see that small spoiler on Seth Wanzing's car ahead. Not a lot of downforce. These cars will dance around a little bit. Reynolds got his way in, winning last week at Martinsville. Trying to sweep the rest of the season here.
Yep, he knows when the chips are down, he knows when it does it. And remember, B-Tron is the championship team over Jeremy Breo. So champion Breo formed the team, had the team, what have you. Trying to keep the championship in the team, if you will. B-Tron has 2 bullets in that metaphorical gun to try to do it. Right now, though, running the worst out of the championship, 4th, 3rd, and 4th, respectively. But to stage one, going to be done in 2 laps time here as we're coming to 23, about to be 24 here. See if any of the adjustments or at the very least pit stop strategies, what have you, can try to get some track position for these cars in question as Feather Place about to cross the line here with 2 to go on the stage.
And that there is Josh Gaiman.
Mm-hmm.
Down in 4th position again, all the dots in red. Coordinate All the color coordination is on purpose. Those in red are champion contenders at the moment. And all four are where they need to be so far to kick off this race, and that is in the top four. As Reynolds got loose, we got right on board them. He got very loose, and we'll lose time to Seth Wanzing.
And that's one of his kryptonites. He sometimes can't make those tires go long in a run. And even though it's 25 laps, we'll have to keep an eye on that for 60 laps next stage, or at least next distance to lap 60. But as we hit the final lap in the stage here, Feather Place takes it. Looking back here, you got Tommy Withers betting Donald Ray here. Even though not for stage points, this is 9th and 10th, what would be last stage points. Back to Brandon Feather Place, though. We'll put a new lap down here as he's coming down the old start-finish straight. About to enter 3 and 4 here. Looks like he'll take the end of stage 1 here. He will win stage 1. Well, about to win stage 1. Now he will officially win stage 1 across the line. Wanzu will come home 2nd. Reynolds 3rd. Gaiman 4th. Wright 5th. Marshall 6th. Robert 7th. LaJoy 8th. Ray 9th. And Tommy Withers 10th. So, top four in the championship take the top four spots in stage number 1 as the pace car will drift around the corner and they'll let them pass up here so they can pit this time by, actually. And something that's going to help Feather Place is that look at that spacing he had when he came in on Wanzing. Just enough gap that he can afford to be just a little, if the virtual pit crew gives him just a little longer of a stop, he should still come out with the lead. So a good little play there to give himself just enough gap. Meanwhile, Wanzing, though, going to be under pressure from both Reynolds and Gaiman, who closed up those gaps quite nicely. So we'll see if Wanzing keeps second or maybe some jumbling will happen.
This will be very interesting because Wanzing has the pit box before Reynolds. So Reynolds will have to slow down, if anything, for Wanzing here.
Yep.
Wanzing gets in safely. Everyone else
comes
in.
All hit their marks. No one missed their pit box. Now the question is up to the virtual crews. Who will get out ahead here?
Really good camera angle right here. Car's leaving pit lane here.
Gaiman may jump. Whoa, interesting. Reynolds got the light on the 9. I think the 61 almost got the 9 there as well, but the 9 will hold third. So Gaiman's pit crew gave him a fighting chance there to jump, but Reynolds wound up keeping second, even though, weirdly enough, technically had the slowest stop out of the four, a 14.98. The fastest was Seth Wanzing at a 14.52, so it just came down to the pull out of the box there, and Reynolds was able to get up just fast enough to hold on to get second, I should say. So we'll see how it all plays. But Feather Place will keep the lead, though. That will be Reynolds, Wanzing, Gaiman, and Shoes will be next time by here, so we'll see how they choose up here, and where will race leader Feather Place go? While we're on warm-up here, Carmen brings up a great point in the chat. If you are currently watching, if you do have some bits you have saved up, or if you've watched a little bit here and you want to spend it, predict who you want to see, who you think is going to be the champion here at the end of this race. You got four drivers, Feather Place, Reynolds, Wands, and Gaiman. Only 10 arrowheads, or whatever Carmen's calling them right now at the moment, because I think the name has changed at least once or twice. Thank you. Regardless, 10 of those will get you a vote, so make sure you pick who you think, and the cash show will happen at the end of the stream. Stage 2 will also end on lap 60. So we're going to see the choose here in effect. Feather Place, we'll see if he goes high or low. Stage points will not count for the championship because whoever finishes the highest will end up taking it. So stage points will not matter. It is just who finishes the highest. So as a choose here occurs, Feather Place will take low. Reynolds will go high. Wanzing will go low. Gaiman will go high. So similar to what would happen on a true restart, if you will, in, out, no mid changes there. LaJoy, though, will jump up to the 3rd car on the inside line, though, at least worthing on the note a little bit further back after the first 2 rows. It seems to be a little bit purposeful. You want to be on that inside line and try to get close to the, cut the dog leg as much as you can.
It's a long wait here. This car comes down pit lane, but pit lane's on the old straightaway, so they've got to wait an extra long time to get down to the restart zone. First caution of the night was the stage break to end stage 1. It's been a very good race so far, but now the pressure's about to amplify a little bit. But stage 2 about to be underway. Feather Place leads us off. We're racing once again at Phoenix.
Great launch for that 34 there. Press cars file in. Seth Wanzing looking to try to make a move here. on back. He'll keep third position. I said Gaiman trying to capitalize in the middle groove here. We saw Wansing make that work, and it's three wide for second position right now. All championship rivals. I think one may have to back out here, coming in the three. Make sure they all successfully make it through here. And it looks like Gaiman going to thread the middle, and he is going to go from fourth to second. Right in a split of a second there. Wansing not going to take that line down, though. He's going to try to go low and get that spot back.
Caution's out for the first time. And that's why Withers. And it looks like Ryan Pennell also involved with some significant damage further on in the back of the field.
Mm-hmm. So let's see how that occurs here. We'll actually take a look here. Keep an eye on that orange and black 23 machine. Oh, he gets a little loose right in front of Ryan Pennell there. Nothing the 12 could do. Actually, he ends up hitting the wall even a little bit harder there as well at the end. So just the 23 got a little bit of a weight transfer issue and ended up spinning out.
That's very interesting, actually, because this is the first time I've seen this so far in this race. I don't think Withers even really got to the apron there. I have to double check here, because Searsaw is in his side. See if he doesn't even get close to that yellow line.
No, he just
gets really loose and into the wall. It goes, and that's Proudfoot that gets into him first.
Yeah. My mistake. 22. The 12, I think, takes evasion. And you can see right there, another car goes really low.
Pennell tried to go low and then wheel spin there.
Yeah, and then it kicked high. And then right into the little blue advertising board there on the wall.
Very interesting crash there for the first caution for an incident tonight. They'll have to use their fast repair early.
Yep. At least a positive, this will give Kevin Feimser his lap back. Something else worth noting as well, Edward Marshall has just disconnected. So it looks like he's had some issues here at the very least. At the moment, we'll see if he can get back in here, because obviously he did not have much damage. So it may have been a disconnection issue here. We'll see if he does get back. But right now, that 16 is behind the wall at the moment, at the very least. But Feimster will get his lap back. But up front, it's still Feather plays. Gaiman will now get second choice here. Then Wansing, then Reynolds will be your front four. Still the same. We left at the last restart, just slightly changed. Now, one more thing kind of note as well, I'm hearing from Race Control right now, there is some questions of lane change, because obviously when you can go down there, when can you choose to go down there? Rule in the book right now is once you cross the start-finish line, you can elect to go down or change your lane in courting, but you cannot change it for the start-finish line. So these drivers have to keep that in the back of their minds, especially if you're in the second row. You can't move until you get to the start-finish line, and then you can move. So we'll have to keep an eye on that, and hopefully our Race Control Matthew Kent doesn't have to get put any two major situations where he has to make bang-bang calls here. So Chu's coming up here. What we saw last time was top four went in, out. So inside, outside, inside, outside. We'll see if that follows again here, but it looks like the 61 is going to go low here and buck the trend a bit. Feather Place obviously will stay low. So it's going to be Feather Place, Wansing, Gaiman, Reynolds, your first four here. Then it's going to be LaJoy and David Wright, I believe, the next row. Then it looks like it's going to be Sears and Roberts, and then Ray and Mongold will be your top 10 here. Actually, it'll be Roberts and Proudfoot, your top 10. So pace car going to pull off here. It's gonna be a long road here before they can get to the restart zone. Zone here. Control is on Feather Place. Green flag is back out, and away we go for the second, technically third, if we count the stages, the restart of the night, and already game and going low here, trying to defend off from Wanzing and the rest. Ooh, Michael Joy, I think got just a little loose there. Doesn't Michael hit Joy. Anything, he locks it down.
Yeah, it's out of turn four, and it's out of turn two, isn't it? That's right there before pit entrance.
Yep, he backed down. I think he lost on his own, yet no help from anyone behind him. Luckily, backs down, does not come back up in traffic. We stay clean, and we stay green. Back up front, though, Seth Wanzing right now holding a charge here on that inside line. Got a good run through that dog leg. Going to be possibly on the corner panel here, the 61. It's a little too far back right now, but he's putting together. Oh, Tom Sears spinning in the distance. Around, he will loop it. We'll see if that brings out a caution. Right now, we are still green, as it's only one car, and we will stay green. So single car incident, but back up front, now you see a charge here. Wanzing gaming going low to block it. Wanzing will think better of it, will stay back. Now the 61 trying to take the lead.
He's driving
in deep here. Yeah, he drives in way deep, and he will come up and he will clear the 34. Now the 34 going to be on the back foot here with a 9. Ooh, the 7 just gave him a shove.
3 wide through turn 4. Wanzing shoots the inside lane.
Mm-hmm.
And Wanzing will take the lead of the race.
Yes, he will. We'll see if he can clear here, though. He's got the car. You can see him trying to rotate it. Almost runs into the 61.
Whoa!
There, it's still
trouble.
He'll back it down. Went a bit too deep. You could see it when it was rotating there. I was worried it was not going to hold, and it didn't. He'll keep it from hitting anything, though, but he'll now fall down to 7th on the racing line right now. So Gaiman will kind of avoid that charge. He'll hold off. And now Feather Place and Reynolds and everyone up from 6th on up will be promoted up one spot. That just shows how confident you have to be going into a corner. You saw, and you can see it right there, a move. Reynolds actually getting pounced on by Bren Roberts. So a Sunny Money Racing teammate of the Seth Wanzing there is going to make a move on the 7. He'll get the over-under, but now it looks like Reynolds is going to try to over-under him back and try to clear him. Look how hard he runs him up the racing surface right there. Roberts not running him like he's a championship contender. He's running him like every position matters, because Roberts is here for fun, here for the win. So you're still side by side. It looks like Roberts could get the run here. Now the question is, will Reynolds charge back? No, he wouldn't. Won't. So put Roberts up to 3rd, put Reynolds down to 4th for the time being. Reynolds will now drive in very deep here. Try to clear Bren. Just cannot get it fully cleared yet, though. Roberts will get the run. Still side by side, but now Reynolds should favor out going into 1 here, as he should get the run through the dog leg. Still side by side at the moment, so Bren Roberts not going away here on Tommy Reynolds. Reynolds just have to slot back in line again.
And some of the spoilers come into view here. Bren Roberts, typically in the 1, driving the 54 right now, representing Shriners Hospital. Good cause there.
Yep, very good cause.
Front of the field right now remains Josh Gaiman. It's the 2 blue and yellow cars leading the way. Gaiman's been in this position before, was in the championship four last season and got denied a championship, ended up finishing 4th in the championship.
Yeah, and that's something that can always affect you when you sit there and you're like, what could I have done differently, especially in this format? You're like, what could have went differently? Obviously, it's not linged on him too much, but coming back here tonight, at least getting back in the virtual cockpit, you think that at least in the back of his mind, he's wondering, all right, what can I do differently than I did last year, to at least a small degree at the very least. But right now he's doing what he needs to do. Some would say he had the longest odds coming tonight, and right now he's at least leading the way at the moment. Feather Place holding off traffic, but now Roberts not done with one championship driver, looking to try to maybe make it a 2-for-1 special as he looks to try to get the run here on the 34. Jibber of Noting, you can see in the distance right there, Seth Wanzig has caught back up. He's just right behind that little battle there between Proudfoot and David Wright right there. Obviously a bit of a sketchy moment, especially watching two cars go side by side. You don't want them to end up taking each other out here. Wanzig almost hits the wall there, trying to find as much time as he can to get caught back up here. So he knows when that pit stop window occurs, he wants to be as close as he can and maybe try to jump a car, similar to what we saw Reynolds do to him at the end of stage one. Proudfoot gonna go low, not gonna have a charge here. Wanzing's gonna sneak on around to put Wanzig now back to sixth position. Just now can he get around David Wright? A little back up here. It looks like Tommy Reynolds is gonna have a charge here on Bren Roberts. Just gets the run, not getting it done. See right there, just in the back foreground right now, Reynolds getting very aggressive with Bren Roberts here. Does not want to stay behind that 54. Meanwhile, Wanzing trying to catch up to David Wright here. And the thing is, when the field gets kind of nose to tail, we were talking about it in stage one, we'll talk about it again in stage two, we'll probably even bring it up in stage three. It can be very hard to get a run and make a pass here unless you can put together the car ahead and makes a mistake. Right now, Wanzig's running just a bit faster, but that's not allowing him to really put the car in the place he needs to get. So you can just see here for an example, he's getting close, but he's gonna have to try to drive it in deep, change line just a bit to really try to get to that 42's corner panel. And at that point, he'll have a chance. And even then, you can get side by side, but trying to clear, it's another whole story. You can see cars going aggressively down the dogleg here, trying to be defensive, or at the very least, keep the runs they're getting, try to stay ahead. That Wanzig gets an okay run here. Could have a chance here to answer into one. Oh, sorry, three and four, I should say. Old turn one, and then maybe set up for something in one and two possibly as well. That going down, cutting the dog like the nine is. Oh, now he's got the quarter panel. Will he drive in aggressively here? It bit him in the rear last time he made the move on Gaiman like this.
Got a little this more planted here. Lot,
yep, more planted indeed. Right though, he's gonna get the run from the high side, so he's gonna have to be just as aggressive on ascend here. As he should now officially clear the 42. So make sure he'll come up here, and he will successfully hold it off. So put Wanzig now into the top five.
So stage two ends in a few laps time, seven laps time to be precise. Josh Gaiman leads the way, but better place. In pursuit.
Ooh. Yep, you're going to say Feather Place in pursuit. Bren Roberts also in pursuit. He's getting the run here on that inside line. Highest of the Sunday Money Racing cars at the moment. He's been able to hold off Tommy Reynolds, and now could even be another wedge between Feather Place and Gaiman if he's able to make that move for lap 60. Go low here in his Toyota machine. Toyota on Toyota. Able to get the job done. Meanwhile, this is kind of good for Game. Game's just running his race right now. Bit got a distance, not any pressure from behind. Obviously, that can change when we hit the final stage here. As you can see on the track map right now, again, this is the biggest cluster we have on the track at the moment. You have a little cluster that's about to cross the start finish line right now. That is battle from 8th all the way down to 11th. So top 7, I would say it's actually 6 in a blanket, and then 8th through 11th in a blanket as well. So two little packs are formed here. Third place though, holding off charges, running his line, making sure he keeps that car positioned correctly. Roberts though, gonna cut the dogleg here to try to get a run. very low. I think Seth Wanzing may have just had another loose moment here, hearing on the radio call here. Car's okay, but he's falling back a lot to David Wright here. So, as you can see, actually, Tommy Reynolds making a move. I was thinking about that. Tommy Reynolds actually makes a move for third to catch Brent Roberts napping. So Reynolds now up to third. Roberts, though, not going to like that. Going to challenge back. You see how low Roberts is going, basically almost going into the pit line there. There, not going to be enough. Now Reynolds going to get a firm distance on that 54 machine as we're about to hit two to go in the stage. Pit lane is now officially closed here. Now at the moment, it looks like it's going to be game and fifth place Reynolds, top three in the stage, with Seth Wanzing bringing home a fifth position. Of there's Tommy Reynolds, there's Brent Roberts, there's Seth Wanzing trying to get maybe one more spot here. Can he get around his 54 teammate here? As the white flag in the stage has came out, Josh Gaiman looking good to at least take the stage at the moment. Wanzing looks like he's about to get, you can see in the background there, looks like he's going to get around Brent Roberts. But as the 61 machine entering the final couple corners here, actually, he will successfully. David Wright may fall suit as Threl. Can be up to when the 61 crosses the line. He will cross the line now, and that will end stage number two here. So it's going to be Gaiman, Featherplace, Reynolds, Wanzing, Championship 4, taking the top four spots again with David Wright, Brent Roberts, Proudfoot, Donald Ray, Kevin Feemster, and Ryan Pinnell will be your top 10 stages. Oh, wait, top 10 in the stage. What's worth noting, at least at the very least here, with them having to catch the pace car here at the end of stage two, it's not going to allow a quick pit here, so it's going to allow Wanzing, Reynolds, and Featherplace to get caught up here and not allow Gaiman the chance to pit early, or at least with enough space to ensure he comes out with the lead. So race will be on again for the virtual pit crews, and we'll see who can get their driver out ahead.
Here come the pit stops. Yep, be a very important field. Set of pit stops here.
Yep. Should possibly have, they'll have one more pit, possibly green, possibly yellow, depending on if we get a caution or not. This is the last stage, so. Well, yeah, coming into the last stage, I should say. So pit, they're going to hit their boxes now. Don't want to slide your tires. Do not want to overshoot here. Want to hit your marks. If you reverse, it may cost you time. Gaiman in successfully. Wanzing with a puff of smoke. He's in, though, successfully. All four cars. Oh, Tommy Reynolds missed his box. You can see just a reverse there. That's going to cost him some time. Gaiman already away here. You can see him in the far shot. There goes Wanzing. Featherplace, though, is going to come out second. Cannot use that first pistol to advantage. And you can just see the effects of missing the box there as Tommy Reynolds is going to fall. Actually, he's taking some damage repair here as well, so he's going to lose some time regardless. And he will now fall down to seventh position. So Reynolds electing to fix the car up. Maybe he had a little wall tap somewhere where we weren't watching. The rest of the three electing to come out 1, 2, 3, similar to the, well, actually 1, 2 came in success where they were, Wanzing up one spot. Brian Roberts actually coming back in again here, so that actually will hand a spot to Tommy Reynolds. So Reynolds will fire off at least sixth, depending. Obviously, it could change when the choose cone is activated.
Roberts coming back down pit lane here. Coming in for some extra service, it looks like.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, second time in here. Long pit stop, though, so it looks like he had some damage as well. Maybe had an incident with
He's not in his box. He wasn't in his box. That was, he came down there to fix something. Like, technically speaking, because he wasn't in his box for service.
Correct. Because, his time didn't go up. So, anyway, without shoes about to be in effect here. Assuming Gaiman's going to go low. Feather plays. First time Ted not for Gibbs of a choice. Well, second time now. He will now officially go to the high side. Then it's going to be Wanzing. Then it's going to be David Wright. So, first two rows are going to be Gaiman and Feather Place, Wanzing and Wright, Reynolds and Withers will be the third row. Sears and Feemster and Pinnell and Ray will be your first five rows here.
All right, it's time for the bread and butter. The final stage here in Phoenix to begin. It's championship night for the Ace Red Cup Series. This is for all the marbles. Gaiman, Feather Place, lead us back to green. We're underway once again at Phoenix. And Gaiman got a really good start.
Yep. Wanzo just got a better one there as he'll get a good lunge there. Could get second away from 34 Feather Place. He will successfully clear him. Well, almost clear him. He had the fender clear. He will not cut up. And now Feather Place can answer back here. Reynolds successfully disposed of David Wright. So top four again, the championships now back to being 1, 2, 3, 4. With Sears now the highest in non-playoff drivers. But Gaiman taking off where he ended stage two by leading. But Wanzing not going to allow him to run away too quickly here. Raises the question, obviously we got a long way to go before we see another pit stop occur here, but it does raise at least, gonna pause this question now, we'll probably bring it up a little bit later too. Question is, if passing's difficult, do you try an undercut if you can get close enough? Obviously you'll be hurt on the long run, we'll have to catch that when the stint opens here. But right now Wanzing reeling in, but last time by fastest car on the surface was Seth Wanzing by a couple tenths. Actually Josh Gaiman was the slowest. Ooh, feet play out of foul. Feather Place almost inside wall there. In hard on the inside wall there. 34 machine. Multiple spots lost there. Good, got some damage on that left front here. I think he got loose, similar to what happened to Sears, but Reynolds is right behind. I think Reynolds may have helped him just a tad. Ooh, I'm looking back at the replay here, and I think Reynolds gave a bump to the 34 and ended up sending the 34 around there. Maybe the 34 was getting loose a little bit already out of the corner. 7 couldn't check up, but regardless, 7 did make contact with the 34, and the 34 did go around. So Feather Place not going to be too thrilled at the moment. Going to need a caution to get back in this thing, or at least get caught back up there. Try to first, you got to see if that car's ailing or not. Then he needs to then try to get a caution or something to get back up to this front pack, or he's going to have to drive the wheel off that thing, as now he's gotten around Tommy Withers for ninth. But that's going to be a big shakeup here.
Yeah, Reynolds over a second behind Seth Wanzing. It's become a two-horse race up at the front.
Mm-hmm. Again, without that pressure, there's a positive in that sense because it allows you the ability to kind of breathe here. You don't have to worry about Reynolds or someone else breathing down your neck if you're Seth Wanzing. You can run your own line, run your own situation, and make sure you try to match the times that Gaiman's putting down.
In a really good position right now. He just has to try to keep a hold of Josh Gaiman at the moment. He's pulling away from Tommy Reynolds. 1.3 the gap. Now he's gained a tenth in that battle.
Look at that run Wansing just got there. Good run off of 3 and 4. It's going to give him at least a couple tenths back here. Again, once he gets close, though, you'll see the effects of that 30 air. And this is what I was talking about earlier. If you're Wansing, do you try and undercut if the opportunity opens, if the pit stop window opens and a green flag stops? Do you try and undercut? Because it's not going to be easy to pass, especially when you're both running similar times. And we saw that last week when Featherplace jumped Wansing with an undercut. It helped the 34. So now the question proposes here as well, obviously, when that window opens, if we get to out of caution, with both drivers running similar times, what does the 9 do? Featherplace is looking at the time and scoring, keeping an update on Featherplace. Right now, he's got back up to 7th right now, but he is a long 5 seconds back of Josh Gaiman. He's got a little bit of traffic he'll have to work through as he's about a second back of Michael Joy, who's currently in 6th position. As you'll see on the top scroll right there, we'll give you a good indicator where everyone is at the moment. There you can see about 8 to 9 tenths, almost a second back. As you can see in the far shot right there, a little battle there for 9th as well. 8th and 9th with Withers and Feimster fighting hard there as well.
Everybody's making his way back up shortly.
Gave that wall a good smack there. You'll see it on the left front. The left front there. You can see a good little crack there. Doesn't look like it's hurting for horsepower, though. So, again, you'd probably like to fix it, but actually being behind the 8-ball now, he cannot do that unless he gets a yellow here. And even then, he may still want to try to get track position. So, 34 may just have to run it right now, see if he can make this work. That Cincinnati driver going to make a move on Mike LaJoy. Try to clear him. Still side by side at the moment, and now he'll officially clear. So now Featherplace up to 6, but David Wright's 1.4 up the road, and that just shows you what 1.4 looks like. A perspective where the leaders are, they're about to enter 1 and 2 as Featherplace has just crossed the start finish line here. So 5 seconds is a long way up the road. Looking at times right now with 28.25 for Featherplace. Obviously, now he has some open space. We'll see what he can do. But he's going to have to try to shave off at least a tenth or two, at least 2 or 3 attempts to try to get the times to catch Gaiman. Back up here, Wansing got losing a little time over right now at the moment. Gaiman's finding a rhythm here, and he's pulling gaps away. Looking at the times right there, let alone 28.16 for Gaiman, 28.40 for Seth Wansing. Seth Wansing was the slowest in the top 6 that time by. You can see it with the time he lost. So a little mistake there. Bobble cost Wansing some time. Looks like it's still beginning to fall here. It's another tenth or two lost. I'll check the line here for the times. Gaiman comes across with a 28.29. Wansing, though, gets it back on the start-finish right there. Still a loss, so a 28.31 for him.
Lines right now on Josh Gaiman, leading the way by 1.2 seconds. Trying to set sail on the championship here. Looking for the back. Multi-car battle between LaJoy, Withers, and this Proudfoot, a lap down. First car lap down, a car loose. That was Kevin Feimster, still loose.
Single car, though, he's coming up the surface, but looks like the two cars will get around him. Sears almost hits him, but will not hit him. And we stay green. Sears was just trying to get his spot in the corner, and the 21 just happened to be right on his line. And actually, Sears was coming in, though. So I think Sears had an incident with Pinnell just a lap earlier. So he was coming in to fix up the car and while trying to pit. 21 happened to be on his line. And then almost ended catastrophically. That orange and blue 61 pulling away here. North noting right now, both car, again, second and third place running kind of identical times here. Again, gaming with a slight advantage, but they're both running better times than Tommy Reynolds, who's beginning to fall off a bit here. And we were saying it was a two-horse race when that incident with him, Tommy Reynolds, and third place happened. It has opened up even more. So Reynolds going to be in a situation where he needs something to get back this field back bunched up. By again, one game in faster. So Gaiman is just doing what he needs to do at the moment. He's putting down the times he needs to put down and is showing. I think looking at the times, his 3 and 4 is his best corner right now in comparison to that 9. Just needs to keep doing what he's doing. It'll be cake and ice cream at the end of this thing.
Leads by about a second and a half. Ben Roberts beginning to hassle Tommy Reynolds again for that third spot. Fed a place up to sixth. Now over Mike LaJoy trying to chase down David Wright, but needs a lot of help to get back into this fight right now as things currently stand.
It doesn't help that right now is feel. Oh, I was gonna say it's getting spaced out, but they are pretty racy back there with the Joy, Proudfoot, Withers, and Ray. They're all in a bit of a pack here. And here's also Roberts and Reynolds rekindling their battle that they had at the end of stage two here. As Roberts is slowly trying to reel in. Remember, it takes two cars to cause an accident here for control to call it. Even then, we'll have to see on that point. Right now, a lot of single car incidences, but not enough to really get a second car around. And with more cars pitting and having problems, with less cars on the track, the likelihood of a caution goes down, which is not what if you want, if you're a fan. The 9, the 7, or the 34, you like hearing at the moment.
That's beginning to tick away here, coming to about 65 laps to go. David Wright now in this mix as well. Third place not far behind. And as you mentioned, you got that three-car battle right now with Withers, LaJoy, and Ray all in tow. Two cars officially out of this race. Edward Marshall and Austin Mongold will not see the finish of the season.
Mm-hmm.
Tom Sears in pit lane with for extended repairs at the moment.
Try to get back out of here if he can, but with that clock ticking over here, he's just trying to finish this race under his own power, if you will. A little further back, you've got a battle between, Wright and Roberts under a fight here.
Yeah.
I think Roberts will hold the charge off of David Wright, but David Wright now coming back here, and there you can see Feather Place. Again, he's made inroads, kind of, but he's not really caught inroads to the leader, but he's made inroads to this pack here, which is not the most helpful thing in the world, but at least it's getting him closer, so if something were to happen, he could be in a spot to capitalize. As Wright almost clears there. Now should get officially cleared. Yes, he will. So put Wright up to fourth, and Roberts down to fifth. And now Feather Place going to try to join this fray.
Better place not far behind. Gonna pull off a recovery drive here. Better place the lowest now of the four championship drivers. Stardust race on pole position.
We know that 34 has good long run pace. We've seen him countless times this season. He's made that long run in the car work perfectly, and we know he's got some long run speed, but the problem is he's got to come from deep. Tom Sears now officially left the pit lane, so he's now back on the circuit doing laps, but multiple laps down, 13 to be exact, just looking to get a good finish for Lime Power and the constructors. Place now getting a run here. Make anything occur. Lunzing beginning to really fall off here. He's now close falling into the clutches of Tommy Reynolds here. He's having really bad laps here at the moment. There goes third place going through the dogleg here. Still side by side, gonna lean on that 54 just a bit. You know the old saying, why use four wheels when you can use eight? But you can see the bit of desperation here at the moment. Also battle for second, raising on it as well. Tommy Reynolds is now trying to get around Seth Wanzing here, as Wanzing has fallen off a cliff here, and it's catched up to Reynolds here and David Wright as well. Tommy Reynolds has now successfully gotten around Seth Wanzing. You know, Feather Place is still having a bit of trouble here, trying to get around the 54 of Bren Roberts. David Wright has also just got around Seth Wanzing as well. Seth Wanzing beginning the fall. He's now down to fourth, so he has kind of burned up his stuff a bit here. And that's bad. Those guys are two up the road here of the battle we're currently watching with Bren Roberts and Brendan Feather Place here. So third place begins to chip away. We are coming close to that pit stop window opening up here. Cars have to take one more service here to finish out this race. Such a commanding lead. Josh Gamer does not really have to answer anyone's major strategies. Got to just watch the tower, watch his calls, and come in when he needs to, and he should be good. Meanwhile, Reynolds, Wanzing, and Feather Place will all have to roll the dice here to try to get at least some time. Make something happen.
Seth Wanzing's falling behind David right there. David Wright actually right there on Tommy Reynolds here. And it's battle for second place.
Yeah, Wanzing has fallen off. Kind of the tires have really hit hard there, and he has fallen down to fourth.
out of place, trying to get around Ben Roberts here. Looks like he's getting close. This is the battle for the top five at the moment. Better place gets to the inside as Wanzing comes down pit lane early.
Yeah, I can understand that he was losing time hand over fist. He's got to try something.
Yeah, absolutely got to try something. So Wanzing comes down pit lane, gets to get some fresh tires and top off the fuel. With 50 laps to go, does that push someone's hand into making a cover here? Better place. Still side by side with Roberts. No reaction yet from the top five in this race regarding Wanzing's strategy call.
I think it's a tad early, and especially if you're gaming, you don't have to really counteract that right now at the moment. Especially knowing that that nine lacks long run pace, you can kind of just do your own thing and pit late and race him back down. Tommy Reynolds will answer that charge, and he is now in. So the second championship of the four, you'll see him on the inside. He is now in.
Race leader's not in yet. Interesting here.
No sign of the 61 and 34. And I think Gaiman believes if he goes long, he can kind of just run him back down. He has that big of a gap. It's Wanzing will have to throw hot laps. Same thing with Reynolds. In order to try to catch him, and then we saw the fall off. So Gaiman rather have fresh tires and try to chase down than be in a bad situation. He's now actually put the 21 and a lap down here as he's caught some lap traffic of the 21 and the 14. Small cool down. Featherplace now in as well. So Featherplace taking his service as well here.
Gaiman stays out another lap here.
Yep.
Very interesting.
Looking at deltas, it's a doing quick math, it's about a 55, 56 pit lane time here, about a minute. And it was about a 5 second gap, 5 to 6 second gap when both drivers came in for service. So I have to do some math here. Now the 61 coming in, though, to cover it off. He is now officially in, unless he's taking the Roberts line, which I doubt. And he is now officially in. Do not speed if you're the 61. He'll get it woe down, cough a bit of time. Now the question is, he will probably come out with a lead, but by how much? Seth Wanzing will come around here and unlap himself. Worth noting as well, Tommy Reynolds was able to hold the spot on Seth Wanzing. So even with the undercut, it was not enough for Wanzing to jump back Reynolds. So I don't like the odds high here that it's going to be that close of a gap here. Gaiman's still in his box right now. Officially got the tires on the jack here. Side's now up for the 61. He got a Josh Gaiman got a penalty. Josh Gaiman is officially sped on pit lane. Gaiman officially made a mistake there.
That's a mistake. I wondered because it seemed like he tried speeding up to close off time. And I think he may have got himself a penalty there. He is still on pit lane.
Yeah, and that's 45 seconds.
Yeah, that's a 45 second penalty. Yeah.
Officially confirmed that. Now he's got a danger going one down here.
That is huge. Withers in, Donald Ray is in.
Yeah,
and Reynolds will take the lead of this race.
Yep, Gaiman now officially away. So now it's open up for Reynolds.
Reynolds and Wanzing.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. What a disaster for Josh Gaiman.
You got a feel for him on that one. I said he's a bit streaky. He has problems finishing things off. And right now, it's shown. He could have been conservative. Obviously, I don't want to sit here. Hindsight's 20/20. It's not over yet. Caution comes out. Anything could change. But at the very least, he's now two down. It's not looking good for the 61 to take the title. He was looking to walk away. And now the door is open for the 7 and the 9 as they will fight this out here. And we know the 7's got a better long-run car. So right now, the 7 is smelling roses here. One B-tron car's mistake opens the door for another one success. If no one last time by, Proudfoot sets the fastest lap of the race. Currently two down at the moment as well. Right now, though, Roberts and Pennell still out long here. Reynolds and Wanzo both have unlapped themselves. So if a caution were to come out, they would not be one down, have to take the wave around.
Caution's out. Caution's out. For the first time, it's for Fetter Place. For Brandon Fetter Place. One of the championship contenders trying to get around David Wright. What happens here with Fetter Place? Is there contact between the 42 and the 34? Looks like a little bit of net code.
Oh.
Net code triggered that contact.
Mm-hmm.
And then David Wright finished it off.
The thing is, both cars are battling. Basically, we're both one down. Time of the caution. So Wright, neither should get the lucky dog here at the moment, at the very least.
Both of them were on the lead lap because...
Oh. Good.
They had already gotten around Bryn Roberts.
Oh, good. So this is the shakeup here.
And that hurts Josh Gaiman even more because he's not going to get free pass because he's third car lap down. First car lap down is Kevin Feimster.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
That's going to be painful.
100%.
Actually, hold on. No, it looks like it might actually end up being...
Donald Ray?
No, Michael Joy. Joy.
Yeah, because I had a few more lap down here. Donald Ray was still one down. Withers is one down. Wow. Just one down. Proudfoot's one down. Gaiman's two down. So Gaiman is buried under a bunch of cars here.
That changes a lot of things.
So as you can see, LaJoy going to get the lucky dog. Reynolds and Wansing will both pit here. We know that 9 has a better short run car here. Reynolds has a little bit of trouble getting going.
So in reality, you got
Fetter Place. Nope. Go ahead.
So David Ryan and Fetter Place were a lap down in that situation because Ryan Pinnell was the one that stayed out. Ryan Pinnell was where that balance was at. Pinnell's coming in now, so that'll put a lot of these cars back. Yeah, they have to take a wave run to get back on lead lap, but they'll get back on lead lap this way.
Yep.
But that's huge. That's very huge. Meanwhile, Reynolds and Wansing got a fresh reset off of that. Yep, and now they're nose to tail.
Yep. Fetter Place will get back on the lead lap, but the cost of is that he will not have the tire advantage compared to the cars around him.
Yeah.
So he'll get his lap back. He'll have a chance to pack, but he'll need another caution to try to equalize what the 7 and 9 just did.
Yeah. Getting on lap 119 of 156 here at Phoenix.
Mm-hmm.
Second caution for an incident. Fourth caution overall in this race.
One more thing worth noting as well. Brent Roberts has the lead, so he'll have choice first. Then it's going to be Reynolds, then it's going to be Wansing. So it raises a question, is that if you're Wansing, does Reynolds stay tech second in line? And if you're Wansing, do you go high? Or it's interesting to see what Reynolds does may counteract what Wansing does. Do you go high? Do you take low? We'll have to see. But you both got fresh tires, and what do you think will give you the best chance? This is maybe what championships are made of, and with how hard it is to pass, this decision could be the decision maker. Roberts will go low, Reynolds will go low, Wansing will go high. So Wansing feels comfortable taking the front line, front row. He thinks he can out-duel the 7 going into 1, being in the front row, than being in the second row. So the field gets bunched up here. It's going to be the 54 and the 9, then the 7 and the 14. The 14's a couple down along with... Then Mike LaJoy is now 4th. Gaiman there in 6th, but not technically in 6th in track. He's still 2 down, currently in 12th. So we're actually going to get this delayed one lap here, allow the rest of the Lucky Dog cars to get caught up. Ooh, we had a wreck, actually.
Ryan Pinnell?
Yeah. Maybe, because I heard control say wreck.
Not sure what happened here. Looks like they're extending this caution by a lap.
Ryan Pinnell is smoking, so he is blown up.
What happened to Ryan Pinnell here?
I think he lost it coming on his own.
Ooh, yeah, he did.
Mm-hmm.
And he already uses fast repair too, so that's a big time loss there for Pinnell.
Yep, the engine is now gone, so that is probably going to be donezo for him. So Pacer going to come in. 35 laps to go, give or take. It's going to be Wanzing on the front row, along with Roberts. Reynolds, next championship contender, is going to be in the second row. Gaiman's there on the outside, but Gaiman is not for position. He's currently two down. He's going to have to try to get around these cars and then try to get some luck here. We'll see how it all plays out. Rest of the cars on the inside line, all on the way of front. Feather Place, the other championship car, is there. Going to be on Roberts' control. Green flag is out, and away we go. Roberts going low, covering off Reynolds, maybe trying to allow Wanzing something, or Reynolds going to try to clear. He will put Reynolds up to second. Wanzing, though, going to go to the inside.
Now Wanzing's to the inside lane.
Oh, he doors the seven.
Remember, Josh Gaiman's in this mix as well, but he's a lap down.
Gaiman wants to get around these. Yeah, Gaiman wants to get around these cars just in case another caution were to occur.
He's two laps down.
Mm-hmm. If he could put himself one down, he'd be competing with Proudfoot and Feimster. Reynolds, Wanzing, Gaiman. Gaiman trying to get back in the lucky lead. Get one down. Reynolds, Wanzing going to try to spit the middle. We saw Gaiman do that on the restart stage one. Wanzing going to try to do it. Less success. And now we'll get sheltered off by Gaiman. Reynolds holds spot. Wanzing want the slot in the third at the moment.
Reynolds, the race leader right now. Gaiman just trying to get laps back here, trying to get himself back in contention, knowing right now he's in the same position he was a year ago.
And remember, Feather Place is also in the distance there, about 1.4 back.
Yeah.
Yeah. Doesn't have the tires, but he does have, at least if something were to happen, he could be there to capitalize.
He's in the cap bridge seat if something goes wrong, because these two are going to be physical, the 7 and the 9.
Mm-hmm. Reynolds, you know, Reynolds will be aggressive. He needs to be aggressive. We've seen it countless weeks. Wanzing, maybe a little less aggressive, but not going to be a doormat either if the situation provides.
Right. Obviously, now, Josh Gaiman is Wanzing's best friend, because he can hold up Reynolds if he needs to.
But also, Brent Roberts is Seth Wanzing's best friend to a degree. If he can get a run here, could challenge and put effect on Roberts. We know Roberts has had the pace to keep up with a 7. The only downside, like I said, is the 9 seems to struggle on long runs. He almost hits the wall there. Roberts is not going to really probably put the pressure on the 9, though, to really get him going. Any other car would be trying to attack that 9. Roberts may give the 9 a second chance here to get himself going.
Yeah, the difficulty here between teammates, Roberts and Wanzing are teammates. Roberts is not in championship contention. With Gaiman and Reynolds, they are contending against each other right now for the championship.
Mm-hmm.
So it's not quite all friendly guns and roses here.
At the same point, Gaiman being off strategy, doesn't really have to threat him being still one down. He'd still have to get another caution. Then Proudfoot, if Proudfoot and Feimster were the cause of the accident, then it would go to Gaiman. But if not, it's not going to matter. The Wanzing gets a great run off the corner.
That was a really
here.
Good move. Got really close there, sitting under the corner. Just couldn't get the overlap there. But these two sitting it in pretty hard, putting everything on the line right now.
Fighting like there's no tomorrow, which technically there isn't. There's no race tomorrow, so you gotta get it done today. Again, Wanzing has to make sure he doesn't burn up his stuff, though. It's a danger to pass. Roberts, though, looks like he almost got a little loose there. I think he was trying to make a move, but thought better of it. Again, Feather Place is holding time here at the very least. 1.6 back now, early in fifth. Currently behind Mike LaJoy, who's currently fourth. Reynolds going to get a move on Gaiman. Does Gaiman put up a fight here, knowing that he needs to stay ahead of Reynolds? Or has he cut his teammates some slack? Wanzing will follow through as well. Wanzing will cut the dog leg.
Keeping it close here. They're side by side entering turn
they
one.
They are side by side. We saw this last time. The 9 drove in deep but lost the back end. He's going to be a little more conservative here. Not as aggressive. The 7 should get the run, though.
Here we go. Side by side. Wanzing still loose out of the corner. Just couldn't get the power down on the exit of turn 2. Reynolds holds onto it still, but pressure is on. 26 laps to go.
Monza gets another in on the corner panel there. A little further back, though, to get the lunge. He can get set up one and two here. 34 is not his strongest part of the track.
No,
but
it's not.
If he can keep close or get a good run, he gets set up for one and two, which is his strength.
Better place up to fourth. Gone around Michael LaJoy.
2.2 back, though, so he's going to have to hope the 7 and 9 get racing or end up colliding, because that's the only way he'll get back in this thing. He doesn't have the tires that these two cars ahead do have.
Laps tick away. Reynolds leads over Wanzing. This is a championship battle in hand. Mm-hmm. Reynolds looking for his first championship. Wanzing looking for his third.
Another good run through one and two for the nine.
There by Reynolds. Mm-hmm. We'll give Wanzing a chance. He will not use it, though. Peek to the inside, decided not to use it, and ends up shoving himself wide.
Yep.
Not great for Wanzing there.
Nope, he'll have to get back on the horse and try again. He'll cut the dog leg, though. Maybe trying to set up, back it up for one and two. Oh, Gaiman loose. Gaiman sliding. Gaiman up the road. Gaiman in the wall. Gaiman still spinning. Gaiman around. Gaiman's got it saved, though.
Everyone will avoid him at the moment, but he is... Again, he was just trying to hold on there to the leaders.
Mm-hmm.
Reynolds has a giant advantage right now. Half a second. That Wanzing now has to chip away at once more.
Honestly, there's one question left here. If you're the nine, it may be counterintuitive to at least a degree, but if you think that 54 has better pace, do you allow him to try to run down that seven and try to get it? Right now, they're looking at times. Right now, Roberts is running a bit faster than Wanzing on track. But Roberts is running the same time as Reynolds. That time by the Wanzing picks up the pace, runs the fastest out of the three on the track. Roberts was the slowest. Josh Gaiman has pulled it behind the wall. His night is officially done. He'll take P4 in the championship. Which, again, heartbreak for that 61. Was looking good, was smooth sailing, and one mistake ended up spinning it on its head.
Wild that stuff time so by. Far.
Mm-hmm. Reynolds was faster. 0.2 over Seth Wanzing. This thing, I wouldn't say I worry about, but something worth noting is they seem to be trading laps. Every time Reynolds goes 0.2 faster, Wanzing goes 0.2 faster. And if you're right now in this position of Wanzing, you have to be consistently faster. 19 to go. That time by. Faster car on track was Wanzing by 0.7. 28.21, 28.28. Mm-hmm.
Thing is, right now, Reynolds no longer has the pressure in turns one and two that he did before. That's a big thing. He was having to drive with the rearview mirror on through turns one and two. He doesn't have to do that quite so much now, and it's helping him out a little bit. Wanzing did gain a little bit there.
Yep.
Another 10th.
Yep. 28.26, 28.34. Again, the one thing that's helping that nine is the one will not challenge the nine because they are teammates. The one knows the situation and will not attack them or put pressure on them. So neither car really has to mirror drive unless the nine gets closer to the seven. That time by, though, Reynolds was faster off three and four. And it shows faster time Reynolds. So all time Wanzing gain on the last lap, Reynolds just got it back.
And Roberts, meanwhile, in third place, just slid it out wide there. All eyes right now on Tommy Reynolds, looking for his first championship here in ARCS.
Mm-hmm.
He is again, 16 Reynolds, laps away from it.
Reynolds was faster again. And again, I said Reynolds has the longer, better long run car. His car comes to life late in a run. Wanzing seems to fall off late in a run. Obviously, it's only been, give or take, at least 20-ish laps since the last pit stop. But we saw that at the end of the last stage before the green flag pit stops occurred. We saw Wanzing. He lost time. He kept losing time and allowed Reynolds to catch up and make the move. So now the question remains, what can Wanzing do? Does he have anything left in that car to get back up here? And right now he's just trading laps. Got a good run through one and two though that time by. Faster by a couple times. He'll have to hold that if he wants to go through three and four, make this work.
Less than 15 laps to go, 14 at the line. For those tuning in for the finale of the ARCS Square Cup Series season, I'm Carmen Sienna alongside me, Kevin Young, to bring you the rest of this season of 2023. It's down to this. Two drivers, nose to tail in this fight. Tommy Reynolds leads Seth Wanzing. Reynolds looking for his first championship. Wanzing looking for his third.
Will be the young gun or the crafty veteran. Driver that won the most races so far this season, Tommy Reynolds. Seth Wanzing, the driver that's been somewhat the most consistent, but actually, I don't say consistent, more of a high-low season. Looking to try to end it on a high.
13 last time laps by.
Mm-hmm. Wanzing was faster this time by, coming to 12 to go.
It's going to be Reynolds.
Check your stopwatches. Yep, it's going to be Reynolds.
Yeah.
Yep, Reynolds by a wide margin. Again, trading laps is not what you need to do if you're the nine. Eleven to go, Reynolds. I think actually it may be Wanzing by a tick, but it's not much of a tick.
Yeah, it is. Wanzing by 300ths.
Yeah.
Better place, 3.7 back.
I think Reynolds may have made a mistake or he went in conservative because you see that lunge Wanzing got through the corner. Now it's paying back off here. So Reynolds took it back up the corner. Wanzing took it more deep. See if he can get something to happen. He's driving in hard here.
Reynolds is decidedly better in one, in three and four. And that's helping him out a lot. Mm-hmm. Oh, Wanzing just went really wide.
Yeah, especially in this good corner there.
Target
that's
fixation.
Not going to help him. Mm-hmm. Roberts in the wall just a tad there. Again, with most of the field spaced out, we're probably going green to the end. Nine to go. Wanzing has a... Oh, Wanzing just hit the wall there. Trying to find anything he can to get that time off three and four to give himself any setup here. Deep again through one and two. Wanzing, Reynolds backs it up. And you'll see the time fluctuate for a second, then swing back here as it holds out to a wash. Eight laps to go on the season. They are going to catch Tom Sears here, but with Tom Sears being 27 down, he shouldn't hold them up. He'll probably just pull off, which is news to the 14. After that, the only other car up the road would be the 23, but the 23 is far enough away that they will not catch him for the end of this race. Seven to go. Now the gap is over a second. I think Wanzing, it may be coming close to an end here. Last time by Seth Wanzing, way loose there. Almost triggered a pit stop entry there with how low he went.
And that's just about going to do it.
Yep.
He was trying so hard. Frustration, I think, kind of started building up there for Wanzing. Reynolds mm-hmm. was coming to six laps to go.
It's not a good feeling watching the car. You've been challenging the championship the whole season, driving away from it, and you just can't get the run on him. It stings.
So close, yet so far, with less than six laps to go. Reynolds, what a whirlwind week for Tommy Reynolds. One last Sunday to put himself in this position. One on Monday, HDL Cup Series at Talladega. Turning around, making this three wins in 7 days. If he can hold on for five more miles. What a wild turn of events. for Tommy Reynolds. 8 days ago, he was on the outside looking in.
Needing a Hail Mary to get in. He knew the strategy. He had a win. That was the only way he's getting in. He went out there and he won at Martinsville. And now, coming four to go. I just hit four to go. He's looking good at the moment to bring it home. With this playoff format, it's all about momentum.
He picked the momentum at the right time. 1.4 is the gap. Wanzing trying to close in a little bit. But it's a little bit way too late for Wanzing. Reynolds taking it easy now. He knows he can with three to go. What a turn of events it's been. Mm-hmm. A phenomenal race overall, though. Left it to the champions to decide their fate. Two laps to go here at Phoenix. Tommy Reynolds, center of your screen, has to bring it home to give Beatron Racing its second championship in a row. Jeremy Breo, the defending series champion, got eliminated in the round of 16. Couldn't defend that title. Tommy Reynolds and Josh Gaiman that shoulder that responsibility.
And honestly, you could say it's a half-half, because remember, he started the season with another team in question.
Bandit Racing.
And then he went to Beatron right when the playoffs are about to form. And he's come to start the white flag lap. Eight wins in the book, looking to make it nine and add a championship. 1.7's the gap. Looks like it's going to hold. But what can Reynolds, as long as Reynolds plays a conservative, he should have this.
Do 1 and 2 for the last time. Down the front straightaway. Wanzing knows he's got nothing left. It's all about Tommy Reynolds. What a way to end the season. Tommy Reynolds is a champion in ARCS. He wins the 2023 A-Square Cup Series Championship here at Phoenix. He bests the former two-time champion, Seth Wanzing, who comes home in second place. One of his best finishes at Phoenix. Bren Roberts finishes third. Brandon Fetterplace, the regular season champion, pole sitter tonight, finishes in fourth place, third in the championship. And David Wright will finish top five here tonight. Congratulatory bump again there by Seth Wanzing.
Yep. Pat will also come up and give him a little tap, too. Sanchez and Reynolds not said a single thing on the radio yet. I wonder what's going through his thoughts right now as he will burn that engine down. There's no reason to save it. Burn it till it explodes. I know when we bring him in here for the interview, he will be full of emotional. Again, you bring what the hand gives you. He did have to hold it. He did play the strategies correct. He had to add a little luck, but at the end of the day, championships are about skill and luck. And Reynolds was able to do both. And he will be your 2023 ARCS A-Square Cup champion here. He's still taking in the moment here. Burned down the front stretch. Now coming around here. Probably tried to enter the victory lane, if I'm not mistaken.
I believe so.
Let's hope he doesn't pull it. Trevor Bayne doesn't know where to go here. The Beatron cards in our chat. Smeal showing congratulations. Josh Gaiman as well showing his congratulations as well. Yep, up there he will go, and he will park it right in victory lane. So those still tuning in, do not go anywhere. We are going to hear from the three championship drivers in the championship, Tommy Reynolds, Seth Wanzing, and Brandon Featherplays. And we'll also presumably hear from Bren Roberts-Wells. He was one of the three drivers on the podium. So not go anywhere. Those interviews are about to take commencement here shortly.
We're going to start off our interview. We'll talk to, I guess we'll go down the list here. We'll start with Brandon Featherplays here. We'll start with a fourth place finisher since he was in the championship hunt. We'll start and talk to him about his performance here tonight. Give us a second here. Brandon, this is Carmen from the ABN booth. You got a copy?
Yeah, I'm here.
Obviously, not what you were hoping for tonight. Third place after starting this race on pole position. It was in your hands. Walk us through your perspective on things. And obviously, what went wrong here tonight?
You know, Reynolds doing Reynolds things, I guess. I put in the effort, put in the time. I practiced all week. I probably ran 300 laps or more here for practice for this race. And to be wrecked twice, not only by Reynolds, but by David Wright intentionally. You know, David Wright, he's the joke of the series. So, you know, it is what it is. They kind of stole that from me. It would have been nice to actually have a race for the end there, but just not the sort of racing I was looking for.
Obviously, you had a lot of pace in that 34 car. Again, pole position for you, and you were able to pull yourself back up to fourth position there for you. Obviously, looking back at the season in review, regular season champion, put yourself in this position. Consistency was so critical. Obviously, looking at the season as a whole, obviously tonight's going to end on a sour note. Looking at the season as a whole, what do you take away from this season? Because, again, it was a very long season. To put yourself in condition to be a champion with so many drivers in and out of the series, the consistency was so hard to come by, but you had it in spades this season. What do you take away from this season as a whole, looking just at the big picture here?
It was kind of a success. I mean, you know, I made sure I was here every week. I made sure I you know, put forth the effort. I did a lot of practice, you know, put a lot of time from my personal life into this. And, you know, all the help and mentoring I get from people inside and outside the league paid off in spades. But, you know, here we are again. You know, and I've been critical of our race control in the past, and nothing's going to happen from this. So I will just be dissatisfied and have plenty of time to think about it in the off season.
Obviously, it brings question here, like a lot of things coming up here as far as, you know, the draft coming up here, I guess, I think it's in January now. You know, a lot of people don't think knew you coming into this. Now, I think you're a pretty big name, at least in the ARCS community. What do you feel going into the draft here? Obviously, you built up a lot with line power. What are you feeling going into the offseason here and going into preseason as far as where you might end up going?
I have considered, you know, kind of running my own team. I am extremely, you know, grateful and very thankful to Tom Sears for, you know, picking me up early, kind of showing me the ropes, and really believing in me this season. I would have liked to have, you know, had a fair race to actually, you know, kind of prove to him that I deserve to be here. So, other than that, you know, hopefully, you know, people, they seen the dedication, that I put forth, and, you know, I'll kind of be looking for that. And, hopefully I can come back, with my own team, even stronger.
Well, you did a phenomenal job this season. That 34 car was phenomenal all season long. Rally season champion, race wins to boot. Obviously, last race win at Gateway. P3 in the championship, obviously not the way you wanted it to be, but a phenomenal season nonetheless. I think rookie of the year, I think, is where you ended up as well. So a phenomenal effort nonetheless here. Before we let you go and let you get ready for the off season and get ready for what comes next for you, if there's anyone to shout out and say thank you to, Brandon, the floor is yours. Congrats on a phenomenal season, very well on hard fought, even if the result isn't where you were hoping to be tonight.
Thank you very much. Thanks to, as I mentioned before, Lion Power and Tom Sears, Emma, Edward Marshall, you know, all of their help. You know, it's been a successful season with their help. Thanks to all my friends and family who were watching the race today. Thanks to all the people that gave me help during the year. You know, I really couldn't have, you know, been where I was, where I ended up without you. Thanks to the broadcast, obviously. Max Graphics for painting or giving me the wrap, the Ghost Energy wrap at the beginning of the season. Phenomenal, phenomenal wrap. And just thanks to everybody. I hope everyone enjoyed the race. And we'll see you next season.
Absolutely. Brandon Fetter plays fourth place tonight, third in the championship after winning the regular season championship. A lot of hardware still going to that 34 camp for Lion Power Motorsports. Brandon, enjoy it and enjoy the offseason. Enjoy the vacation, the time off.
Thank you.
That was Fetter place. You can hear the dejection in his voice. Not happy with how this race went. Obviously, things could have definitely gone better for Fetter Place, but he kept his head held high there. Obviously, looking forward to next season already. Definitely has some plans that are on his own here, but we'll hear what he has to say going into the draft here later on in the off season. We'll move on to third place, Bryn Roberts. Third place for him. He was trying to play nice for his teammate, and we'll see how it turned out. We'll hear what he has to say here after his race. He had a lot of pace in that car tonight. Different look for him in that position. Bryn, this is Carmen from the APN booth. Get a copy.
I got you.
All righty. Third place, being a team sport here tonight, helping Seth Wansing the best that you could. Walk us through your race. A lot of pace in that car tonight. A new look, not running the Sheets car for some reason tonight. But walk us through it. Obviously, a special way to end up the season, especially for you, being able to kind of be a part of that effort at the end.
Yeah, that was actually a mistake. I signed up as a Toyota instead of Chevrolet, so apologies on that. I think I even showed the wrong number. I tried to correct it on Trading Paints, but yeah, sorry about that. Yeah, you know, I was in a box here because Tom Sears wrecked me at Texas, and I was out of the playoffs because then I missed Talladega. So, you know, I had to do what I could for Seth. I know Fetter Place and Tommy probably weren't too happy with the way I was racing them, but I raced fair. I didn't put a door on them. I didn't do anything like that, you know, so I just tried to be like Ryan Newman and make it hard to pass. I know sometimes I have a reputation of racing quote-unquote dirty or whatever, but I think it's fitting that I raced the final four the most, and I didn't make contact with a single one of them. That was initiated by me, so.
Yeah, talk to Fetter Place. Fetter Place didn't say anything about any contact with you. I think he was mostly focused on Reynolds and David Wright in his interview. Walking it forward, obviously not in the championship contention, as you mentioned there. You had a lot of pace in that car. We saw that. Did you feel like you had the pace to really kind of chase down Tommy Reynolds there and at least make his life difficult there at the end? If you had the ability to, do you think that was something that was possible for you?
It's tough. It's tough because I chased him down earlier in the race, but the difference was I didn't have Seth like in between us, and I didn't know if Seth had pace or not. Maybe I should have been a better teammate, you know, and been in the Discord. That probably would have helped, but you know, it's tough. Tommy is so fast, and Tommy's the best, and you know, he deserves the title, and you know, I don't think I could have caught him. I think he was on one, and he proved why he's the best.
You did a phenomenal job this season. Obviously, race wins for you once again this season, keeping consistency alive there. You did a phenomenal job for Sunday Money Racing. Obviously, you get to enjoy a little bit of an off season here for ARCS, even HDL still going on. But walk us through your plans now that ARCS season is over. There's going to be a lot of stuff to keep your eye on here between now and February.
I don't really know. I haven't really had the desire to race recently. I haven't wanted to race a lot. I haven't even wanted to race HTL, so I've been having Jared fill in, or I even tried to get Connor Morse to drive the 33. I know he isn't an open car now, but you know, maybe I'll find a series to run that I think's fun. I like driving the Lotus 79. I've had a recent love for dirt, so maybe that's the case. Yeah.
Well, whatever it is, hopefully we get to see you on track again sometime soon. Bryn Roberts, third place finish tonight here in that car for Sunday Money Racing. Before we let you go there, the same one you shout out and say thank you to, the floor is yours. Congratulations on one more podium and off the season and head into the winter off season.
Yeah, a couple people to thank. First of all, Seth for drafting me. I probably didn't live up to the first round pick. Is what it is. I can't take that back. I'd love to race for him again if he's a team owner. He was such a great team owner, such a great teammate. Same with Daniel, same with Cody Pinnell, who was a teammate for a couple races, Donald Ray, Jonathan Holmbrink. And then shout out to Tommy. You know, he made me mad a couple races. You know, we'd get into each other, but you know, at the end of the day, he's the fastest and he's the best. And I'm glad that he won because he certainly deserves it.
Well, Bryn Roberts, you absolutely did a phenomenal job this season. Race wins, podiums, a third place to end off the season here at Phoenix. We'll let you enjoy that off season. Hopefully, we get you back on track here soon on ABN screens. But until then, enjoy the vacation, enjoy the time off, and hopefully we'll be seeing you down the road.
Thank you.
That was Bryn Roberts' third place finisher here tonight. Obviously, we have a couple more interviews to do here. We'll start off talking to Seth Wanzing. We'll talk to Josh Gaiman as well. I believe we'll at least try to gather his thoughts here because tonight we did not do well for him. But we'll talk to Seth Wanzing up next because obviously he's got to be the most heartbroken here tonight after once again coming so close but ending up so far away. Seth, this is Carmen from the ABN booth. Do you got a copy?
Hey, Carmen, I got you.
All righty. Not the way you wanted the season to end. So close, yet so far away. A second place finish tonight and in the championship. Walk us through it on your end, though.
Yeah. First off, what a championship four battle we had all night. We were all pretty even, all really, really fast. I felt like my car was really good when the sun went down. Probably the best when the sun was down or sun was tucked away. I probably could have cleared myself on Tommy twice there on that last restart, and I just wanted to race a championship fair and square and clean, and didn't want to put them in the wall, so because I know I would have been pissed if that were me. Maybe that's being too nice, but you know, I'll probably be looking back on this one for a few days. I had a really, really, really good car. Probably could have took control of the race at the beginning of stage two. When I got that really good run underneath Gaiman, I just put a little bit more brake into it to get some turn up off the corner, off the bottom, so I wasn't so close to him off corner exit. And just the littlest break spun me around with the line I was running. I wanted a lot of rear brake the way I wanted to run the car. So ran out of talent right there. Ran out of talent a couple times on the apron and just, just couldn't get by Tommy there when I had my chances. And probably when I did, wasn't selfish enough. But, I mean, he had, 8, 9 wins on the season. So, he was one of the best guys, all year long. And we'll get ready for next year. It was nice to be a top 3 to 5 guy, I feel like, all year when I ran. And we'll be back and try to turn some of those into wins and maybe try to get number 3 next year.
Obviously, you know, you come here so close and so far away, but this was a marked improvement from where you were last season. Being back in this situation where you had a chance to go for the championship, what do you take away from this season? Again, a huge improvement for you on a personal level, but on a team level as well. A lot of good teamwork this season all year long. What do you take away from this season as a whole going into next year?
Just a mass improvement for me. I know I won 2 championships. And we moved over to the iRacing side and having a full year now of the being on the server definitely helped. I just need that last little bit to run with Josh and Tommy and beat those guys. I can run with them. I just need that last little bit to beat them. I feel like I'm there. I just got to get to work. Got plenty of other racing that I can do over the off season, HTL, and stuff like that in the cup car. But really proud of my team too. Bryn probably had the fastest car out of anybody tonight and stayed out of the way and stayed out of the championship battle as much as he could and still raced us clean. Daniel wasn't here tonight. He had to go out of town. But obviously, he was one of the fastest guys, if not the fastest guy all year, besides Tommy and Josh. And then Donald is he's that Matt Kenseth type. He'll run in the top 5. He'll top 5 you to death and very consistent, sneak up and get 1 or 2 wins a year. So just got to go back to the drawing board and keep improving on where I'm at. But nothing to hang my head about. I'm thrilled with the way I ran tonight. It's just Carmen's second sucks. No other way around it. I'm mad at myself for maybe using the apron too much and burning up the tires because I felt like that was the last little bit I needed to get to Tommy and pass him because there was a moment there on the long run too where I was faster than him. Just I got too loose and couldn't do anything with him on corner exit.
Well, you did a phenomenal job all season long. Race winner at Kansas, your home track. I think that's your first one at Kansas on the iRacing service. A lot of good highlights to take, not only as a driver, but as a team owner. Before we let you go and get ready for the off season and get ready for what comes next on your end, if there's anyone to shout out and say thank you to, Seth, the floor is yours. It's been a phenomenal time watching you race all season long. And I know we get to see you again here on Monday nights, in HTL, but if there's anyone to shout out after a phenomenal season, a very long season, the floor is yours.
Shout out to you and Kevin Carmen for putting on fantastic broadcasts every race. I know I've been in here a lot this year, thankfully, and I've said that a lot. I always try to say that first. You guys put on a hell of a show, and we appreciate it. Obviously, shout out to everybody at ARCS, all the fantastic drivers that run with us at A-Squared. Proud to be an admin of the series. Shout out to all the admins of ARCS and Matt Kent for being our eye in the sky. Shout out to my team, Sunday Money Racing. Shout out to friends, family, girlfriend watching. Had a great support system watching tonight. And shout out to 3 other badass guys that went to battle tonight. I had a lot of fun, and we'll get going for next year and try to get a win in HTL. been knocking on the door of that one too. And then we'll get ready for next year and attack A squared again and try to go for number three next year. Just one spot short this year.
They did a phenomenal job. Seth Wansing, second place tonight, second in the championship. A phenomenal effort, that 9 true for Sunday Money Racing all season long. Seth, I can't wait to see you again on Monday night. Can't wait to race against you a couple times here coming up very soon. And I want to wish you best of luck in the offseason.
Thank you, Carmen. Look forward to racing with you. You deserve a well-deserved time to have some fun on the racetrack with us. So congratulations to Tommy on the championship, and congratulations to everybody on a good season, and thank you to you guys again, and we'll catch you on the flip side.
Absolutely. Seth Wansing, second in the championship, so close to a championship ambition once again. We get to see Seth again on Monday night, tomorrow night in Milwaukee.
Thank you.
That was Seth Wansing, second place finisher tonight. We'll talk to Josh Gaiman. We're going to say the best for last. I know Tommy's waiting to have his interview, but we'll talk to Josh Gaiman since he is in the waiting room here. Would be remiss not to talk to the entirety of the championship four here. Obviously, a lot of them had a lot of hope and ambition on the line tonight. Gaiman, unfortunately, 11th tonight, not where he wanted to be. Obviously, he's kind of already talked about it, at least in the live chat. Not where he wanted to be. We'll hear from him and hear what he has to say about how this race turned out. Josh, this is Carmen from the ABN booth. Got a copy.
Yeah, I got you.
Obviously, tonight's not where you want it to be, but walk us through it on your end. 11th place, fourth in the championship once again. This place does not like you, whether it's an HTL, ABN, ARCS. This place just is not your favorite. What happened for you on this one?
I guess I was holding the speed, like, I guess so perfect down the pit road that I ticked 46 once and it held me for two laps. So, it was just one of those things that happens, you know, that one's all on me. It sucks that it was in this race of all races when I was doing really good, had a fast car. You know, I got out in that clean air and, that was definitely kind of the key, really, was just to be in front. Getting behind people, the car would get, which it was weird because the car would get loose when you get behind people, at least for me it was, and it would just get really snappy off the corner. So yeah, when I had that spin up front, you know, pretty much right in front of everybody, I was just like, I'm two laps down, I'm gonna take my lumps and just pull it off and, you know, enjoy the rest of the night. So you know, we got next year to look forward to. It's gonna be a really long year, so you know, we got HTL still going on, a bunch of other stuff still going on right now. So, you know, I've got other things to look forward to. Hopefully the luck comes with that stuff, but, you know, we'll see.
Obviously, you talk about this because, again, you've been in the championship four now 2 years in a row, and it's always this track that gives you difficulties here. But looking at this season again, multiple race wins. What do you take from this season as a whole? Like, when you look at, like, what's defined you as a driver, what do you take from this season as a thing that you've really kind of improved on this season that you apply to, obviously, races like in the HTL Cup Series, or if you obviously get to come back and race an ABN Champ car when that starts up in January? What do you take from this season that you've learned as a driver to kind of take forward the winter months here?
Yeah, I mean, mostly being like an off-road and dirt racer for most of the time that I've done anything, whether it's real racing or sim racing. This year especially, I got a lot better at saving tire and working on that. You know, some races I would get, you know, I'd be with the leaders, and then, you know, 10, 15, 20 laps into a run, I'd start picking up the pace and really was able to run people down. You know, it got me a couple of wins, and that was good. So hopefully next year I can improve on that and, you know, maybe work on some other things that are definitely lacking. You know, I'm definitely still working on running races that are, you know, not flat out 90% of the time. So it's definitely a, you know, learning process, and I still, you know, not hanging my head low. It's fourth place in the championship after, you know, 39 weeks. So it's nothing to really shrug at. So, you know, I'll take it.
You did a phenomenal job all season long. We get to see you again still on several nights a week here on ABN coverage here. Before I let you go, though, and let you get ready for tomorrow night's race at Milwaukee, it's going to be an interesting one in the HTL Cup Series in these cars. Does anyone want to shout out and say thank you to? The floor is yours. Again, a phenomenal season, multiple race wins, and another Championship 4 appearance here tonight.
Yeah, definitely shout out Jeremy for bringing me into B-tron. It was a lot of fun racing with the guys this year. You know, it was just pretty much getting into the chat as early as possible and, you know, just kind of, you know, bullcrapping back and forth and just trying to figure out where to get pace and if we were, you know, looking for a short run or a long run or, you know, just how we thought the race was going to go. It was definitely good to have people to kind of bounce ideas off of all year. You know, excited to see what happens next year with that. You know, might go somewhere else. Who knows? You know, the draft will be the draft and we'll see. You know, shout out to pretty much, you know, everyone else for just racing hard all year. It was a lot of fun. So there were, of course, frustrating moments. You know, some tracks just don't race good. It is what it is there. Shout out to 213 Simware, McCody Setup Shop, W Energy. Hoping to keep those relationships moving forward into 2024 and hopefully further. Maybe pick up some more logos on the car. Who knows? Definitely shout out to the admins and for you for putting on these broadcasts every week.
Absolutely, you did a phenomenal job here. Fourth place finish here for Josh. Fourth place in the championship season for Josh Gaiman after a disappointing night, ending in 11th place finish here. We get to see him again tomorrow night at Milwaukee for the HDL Cup Series. But Josh Gaiman, once again, a championship contender forever and always, it feels like, here in the ARCS A-Squared Cup Series. Josh, enjoy the night. We'll be seeing you tomorrow, hopefully, with another interview, this time on better terms, hopefully in the top three.
Hopefully.
That was Josh Gaiman. 11th place finish tonight, fourth in the championship. Obviously, he's got a lot more on his plate here going into the winter months here, so he's not going to keep his head hanging low for very long. He's going to move on, and hopefully we get to see him again in Victory Lane very soon. But now we've got to talk to the driver that did make Victory Lane tonight and claim his first championship. It's Tommy Reynolds, the 2023 A-Squared Cup Series champion. Tommy, this is Carmen from the ABN booth. Do you got a copy?
I gotcha.
What a season. What a night. You're finally a champion. Walk us through it. Walk us through the emotions you were feeling. Obviously, your radio was completely silent as soon as you crossed our finish line, but walk us through your emotions. Obviously, you've had a little bit of time now as we interviewed all the rest of your competitors and your peers there. Walk us through how you're feeling. You finally got one, and it's one of the biggest in ARCS.
Yeah, you never think you would get choked up over a video game, but it's clearly a little more than that. So, yeah, I mean, it's such a long season, and it's just nice to find. Like, I feel, even with all the wins, I feel like the season kind of would have been for nothing if I didn't win the championship. So, yeah, I mean, there's obviously ups and downs. I mean, there was obviously a little bit of controversy in there, but yeah, definitely not the fastest car all night. But I mean, once you got in that clean air, it was kind of a done deal. I mean, you just got to stay out in front and you basically had it. So track position was definitely key. And if you didn't have it, you were kind of out of luck, basically.
Obviously, a championship ambition. This kind of culminates a 7-day trip for you. You won last Sunday at Martinsville, turned around, won a plate race on Monday in the HDL Cup Series. The momentum got on your side at the right time, and it came on your side in spades. How important was that momentum psychologically for you going into tonight's race? Because, again, you mentioned you weren't the fastest car all night. Federer Place had pole position. Bryn Roberts had one of the fast laps in the race. Walk us through how much that momentum just mentally put you in position to sort of take control of this race and keep your destiny sort of in your own hands here.
The momentum helps coming in because it kind of calms your nerves a little bit, knowing that Martinsville is a short track and Phoenix is a little less of a short track, but same idea. And it kind of helps a little bit knowing that you had that speed. And even when you, obviously in my scenario, when you didn't, and I was kind of falling back a little bit, in the back of your head, you're like, I still have that speed. I just got to wait for a long run, which it didn't really come. But just staying out front helped you. And I think that's where the momentum was, just to keep that mentality of, oh, there's always something better I can do coming up. Like, that's my car will get better, or I will get better. And I think that's kind of what helped you, or helped me, sorry.
Well, you're a champion, finally, here in the A Squared Cup Series. 9 wins on the season, a record there, besting Jeremy Breo's record of 7 last season, and a race win to boot here. You did a phenomenal job all season long. Obviously, we get to see you on a part-time schedule, obviously, in the HDL Cup Series. But walk us through sort of what you're planning on have going to happen. English showing me there. Obviously, we've been doing this for 39 weeks. But walk us through what's planned for you as far as going into the offseason here for this season. You know, what do we got? What do we get to see Tommy Reynolds doing in November and December and January here?
Honestly, I'm not sure at the moment. I do want to do the ARCS short track series with late model stock. You'll be seeing me a little bit more in HTL come the winter months, so that's nice. But I'm not sure. I mean, in my opinion, I don't know if I'll be back next year. But it's just a matter of time. I know my opinion will probably change once that draft comes around, but yeah, HTL is definitely something I want to keep doing. The good group over there and the only short track series here is a lot of fun, especially with those late model stock cars.
Absolutely, going to be a lot of fun. And that begins, I believe, let me look at the schedule. Let me sure I got this out, because I know they released it. I think it's starting either a week or 2 weeks from now. Probably a good time to plug that next in. Week. It is starting next week, the 12th at Indianapolis Raceway Park. So yeah, we get to immediately get back into the car, and I get to race in that one. So that's going to be fun. So obviously going to be a lot of fun. Obviously a lot of fun seeing you in HTL competition. Like, obviously your first time race winner just 6 days ago on that one. So everything's coming up. Tommy Reynolds here tonight. Before I let you and let you celebrate a championship, though, we talked about how important this one is. If there's anyone to shout out this season and just in general, the floor is yours. You're a champion. You're at top of the world here in ARCS. Walk us through it. If there's anyone we'll shout out and say thank you to.
Yeah, I mean, it's a lot of the work that goes unnoticed in the background. Thank you to all the A Squared admins throughout the whole season. Through the ups and downs, I mean, they did a great job. Thank you for the awesome broadcasts at every single race. I mean, it was unbelievable watching them back. And thank you to Smeal Racing Designs. I think every single one of my paints, or if maybe one or two, I think every single one but one or two was made by Smeal Racing Design. So definitely go check him out. And yeah, that's all I got to say.
Absolutely. Tommy Reynolds, enjoy the championship. 9 race wins en route to a championship. Arguably one of the best drivers of the season. Contender for Driver of the Year in the ARCS Awards. I know that comes up in December. Tommy, enjoy the championship. It's a phenomenal crowning moment for you. Hopefully the first of many accolades we see you earn in your sim racing career. Enjoy the championship, and obviously we'll be seeing you again very soon.
Yep, thank you, thank you.
That was Tommy Reynolds, race winner, champion in 2023. A phenomenal job. Results at the top of your screen. Reynolds, Wanzing, Roberts, top 3. We heard from all the championship 4. Brandon Fetterplace, 4th place for him. Disappointing for him, but trying to get himself ready for next season already. David Wright, 5th place. Mike LaJoy in 6th. Donald Ray, Tommy Withers, Brandon Proudfoot, Kevin Feimster running out the top 10. Josh Gaiman in 11th place out of Tom Sears, Ryan Pinnell, with Austin Mongold and Edward Marshall finishing off the season with DNFs 14th and 15th here tonight. Points as they run. This is where it gets all so important. Tommy Reynolds, a race winner here this evening, takes the championship ahead of Seth Wanzing, Brandon Fetterplace in 3rd, Josh Gaiman 4th place in points. David Wright finished 5th in this race. Finished 5th in this race. He finished 5th in the points. Daniel Michel 6th place. Oberstadt 7th. Kevin Feimster in 8th place as this season came to an end. Tom Sears in 9th. Then it's Withers, Pinnell, and Roberts top 12. Kruger, Breo, Leiter, and Pinnell in the top 16. That culminates the championship here in the A Squared Cup Series. It's been a very long 39 weeks of racing. We're glad you joined us, whether it was for one race, 12 races, or all 39. We appreciate you spending your time with us here on ABN Esports One for the entire season. We have a lot more coming up here very soon, including tomorrow night, the HGL Cup Series from the Milwaukee Mile. It'll be myself and Christina Ryan in the booth for that one. And we get to see myself and Kevin Young back here on Tuesday night at Milwaukee for the HGL Hammerdown Truck Series. Tommy Reynolds is a champion for the first time in ARCS in the A Square Cup Series, and what a earned championship it is. But on behalf of everyone here for ABN Studios, for ARCS, for Garza Mustangs in the A Square Cup Series, for Midwest Barbecue and all of their partners, and for all of our partners here on ABN, my commentator Kevin Young, I'm Carmen Sienna. Thank you all so much. Stay safe, stay healthy, have some fun. We'll see you tomorrow at Milwaukee. Take care, everybody. Virtual.